video we have seen the first chapter, and now we will be learning about second and third chapters, namely Kashyapa Samhita and Vayubheda. Chapter 2, Kashyapa Samhita. Introduction to this will be: synonym is Vriddha Jivakiya Tantra. Kala 600 BC. Kashyapa Samhita is considered to be the best Ayurvedic textbook written on Balaroga and Balachikitsa. It covers all aspects of Ayurveda but has given focus on Kaumarbhridya more. Utpatti. Brahma, Daksha Prajapati, Ashwini Kumar, Indra, and then Kashyapa. Sthana and Adhyaya. Sthana and Adhyaya. So please people, have a look at this table. Importance. Lehanam Adhyaya. An entire chapter dedicated to Lehana for children. Specific posology for drug admiration and Shodhana Dravya for children. Acharya Kashyapa has emphasized the importance of therapeutic dose for children. Further, he explained to make the formulation palatable for the children. The significance of the best quality of milk for proper physical and mental growth and development has been described. Dentistry. Description of the physiology of teeth eruption with reference to its time and fall of temporary teeth, ideal dental arrangement. Vedanam Adhyaya. An entire chapter dedicated to 34 diseases of children along with their Purva Rupa and Pratyatma Lakshana. In the context of Balagraha, 20 grahas has been discussed and each one of these is different from that told by other authors. The special chapter has been dedicated for Dhatri Chikitsa and Yoga like Bala Taila, Rasna Taila, and Meena Taila. The treatment principles of eye disorders in children are described. Acharya Kashyapa considered Ahara as Mahabhaishajya and explained its importance for growth and development of children. Khila Bhaga is found only in Kashyapa Samhita. In Sveda Adhyaya, Ashtavidha Sveda, which can be administered to children, has been enlisted. Nasya and its administration with special reference to Bala has been explained. The best type of drinking water for a child based on different seasons has been mentioned. Now the chapter 3 is Vayubheda. We do have to learn this shloka compulsorily and it is very important. If you learn this, like half of the chapter will be completed and you can understand easily. According to Kashyapa Samhita, the time period of conception till delivery is Garbhakala, which has intrauterine life, and the period from birth till 1 year is called Balakala. And in this period, Kshirapa and breastfeeding are done. And the age from 1 year to 16 years, it is called Kumarakala. And in this age, Annada and regular diet is followed. From 17 to 34 years of age, it is called Yuvanakala. And during this age, increase and development of Dhatu, Sattva, Bala, Virya, means youth, happens. The age from 35 to 70, it is called Madhyamakala. And during this, stability of above mentioned factors will be maintained, called middle aged. And from the age of 70 to death, it is called Vriddhakala. And the gradual decrease of above factors take place, which we called as old aged. This was all according to Kashyapa Samhita. While moving, we could also see classification based on Sushruta Samhita. He has classified the time period into three parts. First is from birth to 16 years, which is called Balyavastha. In this, he has again classified it as three parts. First one is from birth to 1 year, it is called Kshirapa. and breastfeeding is done. And from 1 to 2 years of age, it is called Kshira Annada, in which breastfeeding and regular diet is followed. And from the age of 2 to 16 years, it is called Annada and regular diet is followed. While coming to second classification, he has mentioned age group of 17 to 70 years, that is Madhyama Avastha. He has again subclassified into four types. 16 to 20 years come under Vriddhi Vayobheda. And in this age, Dhatu Ashu Vriddhi is done. And from the age of 21 to 30, it is called Yuvana. And it is mixed status of both A and C, Yunavikara. C contains development of the body. While coming to next one, 31 to 40 years, it is called Sampurna, where the complete development of the body takes place. And from the age of 41 to 70, it is called Parihani, where gradual decrease of Dhatu starts. And while coming to the third classification, that is from 71 years till death, it is called Vriddhavastha. Kashyapa of Dhatu, Indriyabala, Virya, Utsaha, natural occurrence of wrinkles, grey hair, kasa, shwasa, durbalya, all the body developed things will get deteriorating in this Vriddha Avastha age. According to Charaka Samhita, he has also classified into three parts based on the time period. Birth to till 30 years, it is called Balakala, and Kapha Pradhana is main in this period. While he has again provided two classifications, that is birth till secondary sexual characters are developed, and it is called Aparipakva Dhatu Avastha. And in this age, immature state of the body, unable to bear stress and suffering. And from this part to till 30 years of age, it is called Vivardhamana Dhatu Avastha, and growth and proliferation takes place. While coming to the second, it is from 30 to 60 years and it is called Madhyamakala. And in this, Pitta Pradhana, strong Dhatu, Indriya, Bala, Virya, Vak, Buddhi, etc. starts developing. And from 60 years to till death, it is called Jirnakala. And the description for this is gradual decrease of Dhatu, Indriya, and Vata Pradhana gradually takes place. And according to Ashtanga Samhita, he has also classified into three parts. First is birth till 16 years, that is Balya, and Kapha Pradhana is main. Birth till 1 year, Kshira Vartana, and breastfeeding is done in this age. And 2 to 16 years, we follow regular diet and it is called Annavartana. From 1 to 2 years, breastfeeding and regular diet, and it is called Ubhayavartana. Second classification is 30 to 60 years, Pitta Pradhana, strong Dhatu, Indriya, Bala. Like during this age, human will have the strongest and all the systems inside his body will be developing and will be fully developed. And it is called Madhyama. And third one is Kashya, which is 60 years till death. And here the gradual decrease of Dhatu, Indriya, all the strength and all the developed activities which have been performed will start decreasing. And according to Harita Samhita, he has given a very brief elaboration in four parts. Birth till 16 years, it is called Balya Vayobheda. And Uttama is superior. From 17 to 25, it is called Yuva. And Adhama means inferior. From 26 to 70 years, it is called Madhyama Vayobheda. And its Madhyama means medium. And from 70 years till death, it is called Vriddha Vayobheda. And it is Hina, means poor. Apart from all these things, we do also have modern classification of intrauterine life and childhood.
Like how the ovum develops into an infant and then into a child, and all the life cycle of that child will be given in this modern classification. First one is prenatal period, where the ovum develops into embryo and which in turn develops into fetus. Ovum takes 0 to 14 days and the embryo takes 14 days to 9 weeks, and the development of fetus takes place from 9 weeks to birth. Perinatal period, 22 weeks of pregnancy to 1 week of life. Postnatal period is in the newborn, birth to 28 days of life. Infant, birth to 1 year of life. And the toddler when he is 1 to 3 years of age. He is a preschool child when he has attained the age of 3 to 6 years, and a school-aged child when he is 6 to 12 years. Adolescence age, early age when he is from 10 to 13 years, middle age when he is from 14 to 16, and late when he is from 17 to 20. Okay, while coming to adolescence, the period following the onset of puberty during which a young person develops from a child into an adult. Prepubescent, in boys it will be from 12 to 14 years, and in girls it will be from 10 to 12 years. Pubescent, in boys it will be from 14 to 16 years, and in girls it will be from 12 to 14 years. Postpubescent, in boys it will be from 16 to 20 years, and in girls it will be from 14 to 18 years. Importance of Vayubheda is, in children, the status of dosha, dhatu, malas in various diseases are similar to that of adults. Hence, the administration of drug also should be proportionately small based on body weight, agni, etc. By describing treatment aspects, Acharyas mentioned therapies also. Okay. To calculate the dose of medicine in children, to access the developmental condition of child according to milestones, for performing samskaras, for example, Namakaran samskar is done after 1 year of age. For the purpose of immunization, to access the various physiological development of baby, also related with onset time of diseases, for example, neonatal jaundice, etc., related with treatment principles based on Shodhana. So that's all the description for this chapter, and the important questions are importance of Kashyapa Samhita in Kaumarbhidya. We have completed second and third chapter of Kaumarbhidya. I hope you all are in a good health, and I wish you all the best for your preparations. Until then, I am signing out. This is Dr. Aisha. Thank you guys for your support.